मैग्नेटिक फील्ड एंड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लाइंस। इनसाइड द मैग्नेट द डायरेक्शन ऑफ फील्ड लाइंस इज फ्रॉम इट्स साउथ पोल टू इट्स नॉर्थ पोल। दस द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लाइंस आर क्लोज्ड कर्व्स। मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इज अ क्वांटिटी that has both direction and magnitude. The direction of the magnetic field is taken to be the direction in which a north pole of the compass needle moves inside it. Therefore, it is taken by convention that the field lines emerge from the north pole and merge at the south pole. Fields are areas where an object exhibits magnetic influence. The fields affect neighboring objects along things called magnetic field lines. A magnetic object can attract or push away another magnetic object. You also need to remember that magnetic forces are not related to gravity. The amount of gravity is based on an object's mass, while magnetic strength is based on the material that the object is made of. Magnetic fields are different from electric fields. Although both types of fields are interconnected, they do different things. The idea of magnetic field lines and magnetic fields was first examined by Michael Faraday and later by James Clerk Maxwell. One of the major effects of electric current in use, without the applications of which we cannot have motors in the existing world. Fleming's left-hand rule. It was discovered by John Ambrose Fleming in the late 19th century as a simple way of working out the direction of motion in an electric motor or the direction of electric current in an electric generator. When current flows in a wire and an external magnetic field is applied across that flow, the wire experiences a force perpendicular both to that field and to the direction of the current flow. A left hand can be held as shown so as to represent three mutually orthogonal axes on the thumb, first finger and middle finger. Each finger is then assigned to a quantity, magnetic field, electric current, and mechanical force. Electromagnetic induction. Electromagnetism created a revolution by leading to the devices called motors, which convert electrical energy to mechanical energy. Experiments by scientists like Oersted and Faraday made a long leap by converting mechanical energy to electrical energy. When a straight conductor is moved in a magnetic field, an electric current is induced in it, and the phenomenon is electromagnetic induction. Faraday's experiment proved that the strength of the induced current depends on several factors, like the number of turns in the coil and the diameter of the coil. strength of the magnet, the speed of motion of the magnet. The induced current can be detected by a galvanometer. Transformers are based on this principle, which consist of a primary coil and a secondary coil. The number of turns in the coils is selected based on the type of the transformer to be made, namely step up or step down. Electric motor. The motor or an electric motor is a device that has brought about one of the biggest advancements in the field of engineering and technology ever since the invention of electricity. A motor is nothing but an electromechanical device that converts electrical energy to mechanical energy. It's because of motors life is what it is today in the 21st century. Without motor, we had still been living in Sir Thomas Edison's era, where the only purpose of electricity would have been to glow bulbs. Electrical motors are everywhere around us. Almost all the electromechanical movements we see around us are caused either by an AC or a DC motor. The motor works on the principle, when a current-carrying conductor is placed in a magnetic field, it experiences a torque and has a tendency to move. This is known as motoring action. If the direction of electric current in the wire is reversed, the direction of rotation also reverses. When magnetic field and electric field interact, they produce a mechanical force, and based on that, the working principle of DC motor established. The direction of rotation of this motor is given by Fleming's left-hand rule, which states that if the index finger, middle finger, and thumb of your left hand are extended mutually perpendicular to each other, and if the index finger represents the direction of magnetic field, middle finger indicates the direction of electric current, then the thumb represents the direction in which force is experienced by the shaft of the motor. Magnetic field due to conductors. In 1819, it was discovered by a Danish physicist, Hans Christian Oster, that an electric current is always accomplished by certain magnetic effect. He observed, when a current-carrying conductor is placed nearer a magnetic needle, the needle deflects to a certain direction. He also observed that when the direction of current in the conductor is reversed, the needle deflects in opposite direction. That means there is a magnetic field due to current-carrying conductor. Further investigation shows that the magnetic field around the conductor consists of number of concentric closed lines of force. If we pass a current through a conductor, through a cardboard, we shall get the magnetic lines These are all closed circles and concentric with the conductor. Now, if we reverse the current in the conductor and repeat the same experiment, we shall get the closed circular magnetic lines concentric with the conductor. If the current carrying conductor is held in right hand by the observer so that it is encircled by fingers stretching the thumb at right to the fingers in the direction of flow of current, then fingertips will point the direction of magnetic lines of force.